Hi, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. In this video, I'm going to show how to collect birch bark, and we're going to take it and prepare it and use it for making birch oil. Okay, I'm on a power line clearing here, and they've cleared some trees and a little bit of few birches here. I'm showing how I collect the birch bark. You work your knife underneath of it and work the edge up like that, and then this bark is slipping pretty good. As you can see, it snowed last night. So there's snow all over everything, but that's how you do it. Sometimes you have to get the knife underneath of it like this and just pry and slide it under a little bit further, pry, just keep slipping it under and prying it up. Eventually you can get to where you can grab it, pull it back, and start slicing it with your knife like you're skinning an animal. Okay, what I'm doing now is I've got this tin that I bought from a thrift store for, I don't know, $1.50 I think it was. I'm cutting the birch bark to fit in here, rolling it up, putting it in here and filling up the can until it's as full as I can get it. On the bottom I poked a couple of holes. I hope you can see that. Poked a couple of holes with a nail right there, right in the center, and I did it from the inside. I poked the holes from the inside because we want the bottom to go down. What's going to happen here is the oil is going to be distilled out of the bark. We want it to drain down to the bottom and drip out of those holes. Okay, now what we're going to do is we've got a little soup can here. We're going to bury it in the bottom of our hole. We've got a hole dug, and fill it back in to where this can is held steady here. It's not going to move, and we don't want any dirt to fill up in here in the can. Okay, we've got the tin buried here and tamped the dirt around it to try to hold it as flat and straight as possible, and we're ready to start a fire. We've got this, got the tin buried about a quarter of its depth is underground, and we're going to build a fire all around it and on it and burn the fire for a couple hours. So let's get it started. Okay, we'll come back a little bit later when the fire's built up real good and show you a little bit more then. Okay, we've got the fire built up pretty good all the way around it and on top of it. Now all we got to do is just wait. Let it burn for a couple hours. I got it going pretty good about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. We'll wait until about 3 in the afternoon and see what happens. Okay, it's been about an hour. I've put this rock on top to try to, in an effort to keep the lid on. Yeah, the lid kept coming up with the escaping gases. So I put this rock on it, and I still see flames coming out from the lid, so there are some gases escaping. What would be best is if a person used a paint can, a gallon paint can, but I couldn't find one this time. Next time, that's what I'd like to use, because it seals so well. Okay, it's 3 o'clock now, and I'm gonna go ahead and scrape the wood away from the fire, scrape the coals away, and see what we got. The rock was too heavy for the can. Can got soft with the heat, and the rock is crushing the can, so I don't know what we're gonna end up with. We'll see. Okay, we've got it all cleaned out. We're ready to lift the can off. See what we've got. Ah, look at there. We got it quite a bit there. It's up to about here. Okay. Alright, the can's cool enough to hold. Yeah, it's up to right about there. Hope you can see that. Right there. Birch oil. Okay, I just wanted to show the harvest that I got. This is from two different distillations of about a gallon of bark each. Hope you can see it. It's up to about here. The second time I did use a paint can. I got the paint can from Lowe's Hardware. It's a national chain here in the United States. You can get empty new cans from them. The problem with the can was it was lined, so I took a weed burner to it and burned out the lining as best I could. Also, when you use a can to, the can that you use, the soup can size can that you use below the bark can to collect the oil, if it has a lining in it, you don't want to use that for on your skin. This is good for psoriasis and eczema, but I wouldn't recommend using it for on your skin if you've used a can that had a lining in it. It's also good, according to internet search, it's good as a lubricant, it's good as a glue. You can take this, simmer it slowly over low heat, and evaporate it down to where it becomes like a tar, and And then as it cools, it can be used as a glue. That glue can be used for like arrow fletching or on arrows to make arrows perhaps, and helping to secure the arrowhead to the shaft. It's an excellent leather preservative. I would guess it'd be good on wood as well, but I didn't read that anywhere. So, that's pretty cool stuff. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.